You have learned row reduction of matrices, and you have also learned how to compute the product of two matrices. Well, at first sight, those two operations are completely different. They are related, however, via so-called elementary matrices. In this video, you will learn what an elementary matrix is and how row reduction and matrix multiplications are related. So, what is an elementary matrix? Well, take the identity matrix, any identity matrix, perform one single row operation, and you obtain an elementary matrix. So this means in particular that all elementary matrices are square matrices because they are obtained from the identity matrix via a single row operation. Well, we have three different row operations: multiplication of a row with a non-zero factor, interchanging two rows, and adding a multiple of a row to another row. So this also means that we will find three types of elementary matrices. So doing this with a 3x3 identity matrix, for example, our first type, multiply a row with a non-zero constant, for example with 2, then we get, for example, this elementary matrix. Second type, interchange two rows, for example, the second and the third row, then we get our second type of elementary matrix. And the third type, add a multiple of a row to another row, for example, add 3 times the first row to the last row, then we get our last type of elementary matrix. So you see, it's very easy to see whether you have an elementary matrix or not, and to make new elementary matrices if you would like to do that. But what is so special about them? Well, we can see that from this example. We have a matrix A, not an elementary matrix, just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And now something special happens if we use an elementary matrix and multiply A on the left with this elementary matrix. For example, if we use E2, then we get this product over here. So we compute it using the row column rule. So for the, let's do the first column, 1, 0, 0 inner product 1, 2, 3 gives a 1. And 0, 0, 1 inner product 1, 2, 3 gives a 3. And 0, 1, 0 inner product 1, 2, 3 gives a 2. And you can do the second column in the same way. You get 4, 6, 5. And what do you see if you compare the product in the original matrix? Well, you can also get the product matrix by interchanging the second and the third row of A. So basically, your elementary matrix E2 performed this row operation on A. And it performs exactly the same row operation as was performed on the identity matrix in this example. So you can apparently do a row operation by on A by multiplication on the left with an elementary matrix. And this is true in general. Suppose you have your identity matrix E and your I, and you obtain an elementary matrix E by performing one row operation. So you have your elementary matrix. If you now have another matrix A, and you multiply on the left with this matrix, elementary matrix E, then the product will yield the same reduced matrix. You will do the same reduction step on A as you did on I to obtain E. Well, formulation looks a bit difficult, but what it basically does, multiplication with an elementary matrix E on the left, it does one row reduction step on your matrix A. You can see that from an example. If you have our matrix 1, 2, 3, 4 over here, of course, if you want to do row reduction, we want to add -3 times the first row to the second row. We can also achieve this by multiplying our matrix A on the left by an appropriate elementary matrix. Well, what elementary matrix should we take? Well, basically do the same row operation on the identity matrix. Then you get this elementary matrix E, and you can verify that if you compute then E times A, as you indeed get use row column rule, for example, on the first column you get 1 times 1 plus 0 times 3, 1, and then -3 times 1 plus 3 times 1, 0. You can do the second column similarly, and you get the matrix 1, 2, 0, minus 2, which is indeed the matrix which you would also have obtained if you would have done this one row reduction step on A. So you see, you can do row reduction steps on a matrix by multiplying on the left with the appropriate elementary matrix.